Oh, and welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Kari Nari, and on here we talk about various different fragrances in my collection. You can let me know what fragrances are you most interested in, and those are the ones that I bring up. All I ask is that if you're here for the first time and you like what you're watching, that you subscribe and go ahead and follow the journey with us. Make sure you like and comment, because I love to talk back with my with the people who are watching me. We can have us a good fragrance conversation. And for all of you all who have been here before and you just haven't subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscription button. It's somewhere down here. So that way you will never miss, and hit the notification so that way you'll never miss any video that I come up with. I waited for this particular video to push it back as far as I could without going into the winter, because this is my Middle Eastern fall scent. But I kind of think they could go both ways. Like, I think it could be Middle Eastern for fall or for winter. So that's why I pushed this one back. I'm happy that you all have returned, and I will not hold you. We're going to get right into it. So let's talk about it. My very first one is one that is so affordable. You can really get this, I want to say, as low as $20, $25. I'll make sure that in the link below that I do list where I found it at the most reasonable price. If I can't find it at a reasonable price, I will find it at one. But at the end of the day, it's under $50. I'll tell you that. The one that I'm talking about is called Oud 24 Hours, right? So I don't know if this was meant to be worn for 24 hours. But what I can tell you is that this one stays. It stays on your skin. Oh, this stays on you, right? The notes that's in here is dark chocolate, mandarin orange, bergamot, fruity notes, spicy notes, ylang ylang, gardenia, jasmine, patchouli, sandalwood, incense, and agarwood and amber, right? But for me, this is a spicy chocolate. The chocolate note comes off at the soon as you first smell it. But then it has like this incense-y, you get the oud, but to me, argan oud is like the level of oud that you can try to get into oud, right? It's not too strong, it's not skanky or anything like that, right? It does have a floral note. Now, I would say this, do not get this one in hopes that you'll get like a fruity chocolate. This is not a fruity chocolate. This is a spicy chocolate with very strong floral notes, ylang ylang, gardenia, and that jasmine. The gardenia and jasmine to me is front and center. The patchouli is almost like a earthy patchouli. So that, but in the cool weather, this performs gorgeous. It is a bombastic, will stay with you fragrance. Do not think you're going to overspray this one. I would not overspray this. But it does have a nice chocolate note to it. So it's called Oud 24 Hours. Not sure if it was meant to be worn for 24 hours. But it will last a decent time. A long time on your skin. All right, my next one. I originally had the Oud, like the Oud Mood, the original one. And I liked it. I'm not going to say that I did not like it. But I had them both. So I had that one, and I also have Oud Mood Elixir. Oud Mood Elixir I liked better. So that's why I kept this one. This one is another one of those spicy, but this has leather in it. Like leather, oud, tobacco. It has like this beautiful musk note to it, but not like overbearing. The actual notes in it is saffron, nutmeg, cinnamon, argan oud, suede, sandalwood, amber, and vanilla. And I will tell you, you're going to get that soft, buttery, suede note. So the leather in here, to me, was palatable. Like, it was very enjoyable for me. And the nutmeg that's in it and that cinnamon kind of gave you that spicy, coziness to it. Now, the saffron is not front and center. So if you're a saffron lover, this is not saffron heavy. Saffron is an opening and then it's gone. The nutmeg and the cinnamon takes over. But this probably would be gorgeous. Gorgeous as a starter cinnamon fragrance. And I want to say I have a video, and I'll make sure I post it right here, that talks about my cinnamon fragrances. And this one is in that one. It's a very good cinnamon starter fragrance. But in cold weather, you need to be spicy and sexy, right? Oud Mood Elixir. I think this one would be gorgeous. Now, my next ones is, if you haven't got into Latafa, but this is like the sister company of Latafa. I want to say it's the same company. He just probably changed and used his whole name on one and his last name on the other, because this is Maison Alhambra Latafa, right? So I just think that when he initially came out, he just used Latafa. But this one here is, and so all of these are going to be takes on or their interpretation of another fragrance, right? So the first one I have, and I'm going to make sure that I get it up. So if you haven't got into Latafa, like I was saying before, you haven't got into Latafa, then you should. So all of these are going to be their take on different fragrances, right? This one here, the first two I'm going to talk about is their take on Carolina Herrera's, I want to say it was her premier line. But at the time when I got into these was because you couldn't find them. And if you did find them, it was like a crazy price for them. Now, of current, you can actually find them on Fragrance by CA. But when you see that on there, you got to get it. You got to get it quick, because as fast as they can put them up, it's as fast as they are selling them. And I want to say they're selling them for under $200. But the first one is going to be Exclusive Saffron. Exclusive Saffron is their take on Saffron Lazula, I want to say, by Karen Herrera. Now, I wanted to make sure I pull both notes up to see. And looking at both notes, it has some similarities, but not exact. But so, because I haven't smelled the actual Carolina Herrera's one, if it smells anything like this, then I know it's beautiful. I know it's absolutely beautiful. The notes in it is going to be black currant, tonka bean, saffron, rose, iris, vanilla, garac wood, leather in it. And this is so sexy. It is so gorgeous. Now, for me, it's a unisex fragrance. This can be worn by men and women. A very confident woman. But I think on a man, this would be absolutely beautiful. But again, all the ones I'm telling you about are ones that I think that is cool weather, but can still hang in there when it got cold, right? The Saffron Lazula, I want to say, is, and it has all the same notes. Only difference is that there's vanilla in the original one. There's a leather note. I want to say it's a leather note in here. So yeah, I would say that it's just that even though they put vanilla in their copy of it, I think that it's in the order of how they did the fragrances. Like the top notes on the original is more saffron, blackcurrant, and tonka bean, right? Whereas the opening on here is more blackcurrant, tonka bean, and then a little saffron. I want to say Carolina Herrera's have more saffron. That might be the only difference to me. But either way, if the original smells like this, it's gorgeous. It's absolutely gorgeous. My next one is their take on Burning Rose, and it's called Exclusive Rose. I love this one. I absolutely love this one. I truly, truly, truly love this one. It is so pretty. It's so, oh, I love this one. So much so that I have actually smelled Burning Rose, and I still like Exclusive Rose. Let me get the notes for Exclusive Rose. And I want to say it has some similarities, not exact. It's like the same thing. I don't think that is exact to it, but I think it's some similarities. But the Burning Rose, it's like a spicy rose scent. I'm trying to sit here and think of what was Burning Rose. Burning Rose to me was like a, you had to be dressed up to wear that one. And I still feel the same way about Exclusive Rose. This is not one that you just wear to go to, like, say, go out to the store, just do some casual runs. I think that this is one where you need to be dressed up, particularly in a black, like a black dress or something, or a black suit. The original one has, let's see, what is in the original one? Is Bulgarian rose, cinnamon, patchouli, and ginger, right? And in this one, I think you get the same thing. It's the same notes. I just think that when I smelled the original one, it was more patchouli in it. It was a little more patchouli heavy than I would have liked. Whereas this one is more rose and ginger. That might be the only difference. I would say the only difference between the two. I love Exclusive Rose. If you can get your hands on Exclusive Rose, I think it's a win. I think it's a win. But like I said, if you have the original one, I don't think that is a reason to have them both. I think that, you know, they did a really good job. And then the last one that I have, and all of these are by Mason Alhara Latafa. If you have this one here, this is Tabak. Tabak is their take on Tabacular by Dior. I had no reason to buy the original one. I loved this one. I love this one so much. It was so good. It was so inviting to me. It had honey and tobacco in it. Oh my God, there's a peach note, but the peach note, and I don't know if it's peach. When I first smelled it, it just smelled fruity. Like, it was one of the ones of my tobacco fragrances that just made me absolutely fall in love with tobacco. And I think I like tobacco and honey, to be truthfully honest, because I also like Amen, which is tobacco and honey. And I like Amber Absolute, which is tobacco and honey. So I think I like tobacco and honey together. But Tabak, first of all, look how big the bottle is that you get, right? And I want to say this one, too, is like $50. And the Dior one is $300 for like a little one. So just the amount of liquid that you get was enough for me to lean towards this one here. But I love Tabak. If you cannot get your hands on Tabacular by Dior, then get Tabak. And I know there's so many that are out. I want to say it's so many. Tuxedo. It's so many different Middle Eastern fragrances that are out that is supposed to be similar to that Dior fragrance. But to me, Tabak was the best one. It was the absolute best one. All right, my next one is one that I had heard so many people talking about it. So I was like, okay, well, I have to get it. Because I heard so many people talking about it. And this one here is called Mocha Wood. Mocha Wood is so edible. It is It's so edible. It's almost like you just, when somebody's wearing this, you just want to take a bite out of them. And the notes in this one is vanilla, pepper, amber, cinnamon, cardamom, mocha, sandalwood. There's an oud in it, but I think it's probably agar oud and vetiver. The vetiver to me is what makes it wearable for men. I think all of that amber and mocha and stuff is what makes it wearable for women. So this is another one I think that can be worn by men or women. It's a good purchase. Mocha wood is good. It's really good. Really, really inviting of a scent. Like just like a really good chocolate, but not a adolescent chocolate. Not like a chocolate greedy. This is a well-blended chocolate, like a chocolate with more body to it. I think it has to probably do with the vanilla, the amber, and the cardamom mix, along with that mocha, that makes it where it's not so one level, like just chocolate. I like that one. Mocha wood. And my last one that I have, I just got into my collection, so I'm still kind of trying to find my way with this one. It's, I don't know if it's, I don't know where to wear it yet. Because I've gotten it and I got it closer to the fall. I haven't had a chance to wear it in the summer, so I can't say that it's not wearable in the summer. But I will be reaching for this one in December. So, and it's called Zenobi by Tamavichi. And in here, you're going to get like, it's a, what is it? It's like a rosiness, like a floral beautifulness. It's the black currant, I think, that has me in a bit of a chokehold, but it's black currant, orange blossom, Madagascar vanilla. It has royal jasmine, orchid, Turkish rose, amber, saffron, leather, Moroccan rose, cedarwood, and oud, right? But the oud again in it is not, it's not that skanky oud. That's what I was saying. I don't know. I bet you this would be gorgeous, period. It might be a year-round fragrance. But I'm going to try it out. I'm going to try that because of the leather and the rose and the saffron that's in it and the oud and that cedar wood. I'm going to try and see how does it do in cold weather. But I think that it's going to probably be good, period, because that black currant and orange blossom makes it seem like it could be worn in the spring. The Madagascar vanilla, along with the saffron, I know for sure can be pulled off in the fall. So Zenobi might be one that I can wear, period. So these were my 7 that I pulled from my collection that I think you should wear for the fall / winter, right? So in that transition time period. If you know of any that I have not mentioned that is Middle Eastern, then in the comments, make sure you list them. That's how we figure out other fragrances and what fragrances we might really be interested in. I love when y'all talk back and forth or give me recommendations. If you have enjoyed this video, thumbs it up. That's how you let YouTube know that you like my channel. So on that note, I'm gonna bid you a wonderful night, a wonderful day, whenever it was that you got an opportunity to watch this video. And I'm gonna give you a sneak. If you made it this far, I'm letting you know that I'm doing fragments. So I am going to try to post as often as I can. I will not say every day, but I'm gonna try to post as often as I can in December so that I can give you all of the videos that I feel you should either have heard about, or all the fragrances, should I say, that you should have heard about right before it is shopping time, so you can find the best fragrance for one of your family members. I'll talk to you soon.